Mini chapter 34, Jaymi incarnates Evelyn. Alone at his desk in the Melrose Avenue building, Jaymi clutches the edge of his chair in panicked exhilaration, watching Evelyn slither and squeeze out into meat space through the monitor in front of him. She lands, as if through sun glare, in a desert border town where blue agaves curve along a wall that's alive with competing tags of spray paint. Inside a barroom door, in the slow-turning shadow of a ceiling fan, a deck of cards is splayed on the bar, with the bright cartoon of a different sexy girl printed proudly on the back of every card. Firecrackers burst in the distance, and a smiling-eyed Evelyn with golden hooped earrings swings through the doorway from the sunlight, a belt of bullets slung across her shoulder and down around her bared midriff, wearing a wide black belt over a short scarlet dress, with scarlet high heels, a gun holstered at her right side, and a switchblade knife in her left hand. A lush yellow rose is tucked behind her ear, beside cascading black hair. Beside that rose, her attention comes to rest on her electrified creator, her very first look at him since her incarnation. She stares. Then slowly, she smiles, and Jaymi smiles back. So, there she is. His second beast, Evelyn. He loves her. All the ease and freedom he could create from within him, and his very own response to Bangdead's Galscore, Babe or Gross newsfeed. There's no need to waste time. There is no time to waste. The moment has arrived for her first mission out here in the world. What a joy. He jumps out from his seat, beckons her to follow, and leads her out of EC1 Digital's office, along deserted glass corridors, into the lift and down to the dimness of the parking levels. They take a wordless, dreamlike walk along the aisle and arrive at Jaymi's car. They have already got in and closed the car doors before he realizes he has no idea where he's about to take her. She may be his second beast, but he still feels a bit of a newbie at this. Aha! Of course, she may as well start where the players in her industry are wont to congregate, right? So, he turns to where she's sitting expectant in the passenger seat and speaks his very first words to her in the flesh. Evelyn, allow me to take you to the Hollywood Cafe. Cool, let's go, she breezes. And so they do.